little bit of morning sickness. It's okay. You want me to pack an extra suit for you?
Yeah, maybe you're better. I could get stuck having to stay over. Depending on how long it takes me to find a capable secretary, at least one I can afford.
You know, I've been thinking, I'm sure that there are ways that we could cut back more.
We've cut back enough. It's not going to be as big a change as you think. My main practice is still going to be in the city.
I know. I just wish the new office wasn't so far away.
It's less than a couple of hours' drive. An area that's growing fast with very few lawyers.
So I've got a spot here. I've got to clean this before I pack it.
Thank you, dear.
Okay, so the running back comes on him. You have a four-man pileup. One more coffee.
I better hit the road. Eat. All right, you fellas, mind your mother and don't run her ragged, right? Right?
I promised that.
And make sure you get your chores done, all right? David, I want a good report from the sisters when I get back. And that means first thing after school, what?
Homework?
Exactly. And don't forget your exercises.
Yes, sir. Promise.
One more bacon?
Don't tempt me. If I get any more of a paunch, it'll be your fault for being such a wonderful cook.
Oh, sure. How would you know? I probably made you the same breakfast every day since we've been married.
Well, that's exactly the way I want it.
Take care.
Bye.
I really appreciate you taking the time to see me.
Well, you seem very qualified, Miss Spencer, but I do want to study the applications of the other girls I've interviewed before I decide.
I understand. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Are you Leonard Herrick?
Yes, I am.
I'm sorry. I just thought that being a lawyer and all, that you'd be older. I'm Virginia Breimer. I came to apply for the job with you.
Virginia Breimer, I don't recall your name on the list the high school sent over.
That's because I'm not all that popular with some of the teachers at school. Especially Miss Cummings, and she's the one who picked the girls to come and see you.
So you heard about the position and decided to apply anyway. Well, I must say, that's very enterprising. Please, have some.
Now, you know, I bet that some of the girls that Miss Cummings sent over can't even spell that word, and I can. It's E-N-T-E-R-P.
I believe you.
The thing is, she should have sent me. I am the best typist in class, and I help out in the school office, so I know all about answering the phone and taking messages, filing, and I know that I can do anything that you need me to do. And I can work any hours you need me to work, because it's just my aunt, she doesn't care where I am. And I can do shorthand. I can take shorthand, I can't do it real fast, but I know that I could do it the way you talk.
And how's that?
Kind of clear and decisive.
Thank you.
And I have a letter of recommendation from Miss Bedford. She's in charge of the school office.
Very impressive.
So I get the job.
Well, I'd like to think about it a little more.
No, I promise I can do it, and I work real hard.
I understand, but I've interviewed a number of young ladies.
Mr. Herrick, I really need this job. And I promise you, you are not going to find anyone better. Please.
All right. When can you start?
Whenever you want. Right now?
No, tomorrow will be fine, Miss Brimer.
Tomorrow, then. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. And everyone calls me Jenny, so I hope that you do, too.
Jenny.
That's it, David. You're doing great.
Come on, son. Come on. Very good. One step at a time, that's right. Very good.
I'm sorry, I tried, Dad.
Oh, you're doing very well. You're making progress.
I'll do better.
No, you will. Just keep trying and trying. That's all you can do, right?
I promise, Dad.
Nurse.
All right, now, you go outside, and we'll be with you shortly, huh?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
There's been a slight but significant increase in your son's neural impulse responses. Now, I would recommend that you continue with the speech therapy and bring in a neurological specialist and a physiotherapist.
Does that mean that David will walk?
I think there's a chance, a good chance. But you must understand, the treatment is long-term and, I'm afraid, expensive. And, of course, even if it is successful, there's no guarantee he'll be completely normal.
No, I don't expect that. Nobody's completely anything. He may never climb a mountain, but if he can walk with his intelligence and determination, he can do just about anything.
I want so much to believe that.
It's not just a matter of believing. It's a matter of doing everything possible to make it happen. Doctor, we don't care how long it takes or how expensive it is. Please, arrange for David's treatment. We'd appreciate it. Thank you. What's the matter, darling?
Nothing.
I know when something's bothering you. What is it?
Do you think it could happen again like David?
I understand what you're feeling. But you've been fine this time. Besides, William was perfectly healthy. This baby will be too.
I'll feel better when I see a healthy baby.
I promise you, this baby and the next will be a cinch.
Oh, yeah? Mm. You think that? Okay, I'll let you have them next time.
Mm.
Jenny, about that milk repetition?
Did I leave something out? I checked it real careful.
Oh, it's fine. I just wanted to make sure the certification on it was set off.
Oh, yeah, I remember, because I stopped at the post office on my way to school, and I was late for senior picture day.
Well, you should have told me. You've been working hard. You could have time off.
I don't care about a dumb school picture. Anyway, there's that brief that I finished, so if you want to check it, I can wait and make any changes.
I'll tell you what, it's late, and I'm sure your aunt must be waiting dinner for you.
No, if I'm not there, she just goes ahead. Anyway, I can stop and get some fries or something, I don't mind.
Well, I do. Junk food, it's not healthy, it's bad for your digestion. I'll tell you what. Everyone deserves a treat now and then. I'll take you to dinner. How about it?
Great. I mean, you don't have to.
I want to. Besides, I can't afford to be charged with child abuse.
I'm really not a child.
Have you thought about going to college?
College? No.
Well, why not? You should be thinking about your future.
I wouldn't fit in.
Now, don't underestimate yourself and your potential. Look how quickly you've caught on to things around the office the last couple of months.
That's different. Working for you is easy.
Here we are. Prime rib au jus. And the salmon mousseline. Enjoy your dinner.
Thank you. It's good. Are you looking forward to your prom?
Not really. I mean, I don't think I'm even going to go.
What? You must have been asked by at least a dozen fellas.
Yeah, some, I guess. There's not anyone I really want to go with. I'm not even going to go to my graduation.
Why?
I don't have anyone to invite. My dad left when I was too young to even remember. And my mom moved when she got married again. She lives in Nevada, I think. And that's where she was last time I heard from her.
Any brothers or sisters?
Mm-mm.
How about your aunt?
I asked her, but it doesn't matter anymore.
You can't miss your graduation. It's just not right. That's a memory you should always have.
It's just that I don't want to be the only one without anyone there.
Well, I could come to your graduation and be your escort for your prom if you're not ashamed to have me as a date.
No. I mean, not at all. I don't have a dress or anything.
What? That'll be my graduation gift. You go out, find what you like. It'll be my gift. Date who's old enough to be your father.
But you're not.
Did you want some fun?
Sure.
Maybe you think you got something better with that older guy.
Maybe I do.
What's wrong?
Nothing. I just wish it didn't have to end. You know?
Yeah, I know.
You don't have to go right back to the city tonight, do you?
Well, I should go by the office. There's some papers I need to take care of.
I could come with you.
help?
Are you sure? Jenny? There aren't any papers I have to look at.
I know.
It fits.
Oh, beautiful.
There you go.
Oh, it does. Oh, look at Mommy. Look. Oh, I love it. Thank you.
I love you for giving me the best Christmas present ever. Daniel, what do you think about that, huh? Oh, the boys and I are going to be late for Mass if we don't hurry. Now, you just take it easy, all right?
Look, why don't I get dressed and come with you?
You know what the doctor said about pushing.
But maybe I wouldn't be such a pain if I got out of the house.
You're not.
It's kind of hard for me to accept that a part of my life is over. I'm not going to have any more babies.
I just thank God you're all right. That you're here. Now we have three beautiful children. We're very fortunate, you know?
Did you see this?
Pretty neat, huh?
David, William, time for church.
Do we have to go now?
Yes, sir, we do. Let's not forget, Christmas is not just about gifts. All right, come on, get your coats and hats and off to the car.
Dad, when we get back, we'll put together my train set.
We'll do it.
No. Yeah, just a minute. Leonard, it's for you.
Look, just tell whoever it is. This happens to be Christmas Day, and we're off for Mass.
Leonard, it's Miss Brimer from the office. I think it's important.
Well, I suppose I'd better take it. Yes, Miss Brimer, what is it?
I'm sorry, Lenny, I didn't think your wife would answer. You know, the last thing I ever want to do is cause trouble for you.
Oh, that's all right, Miss Brimer. Hold on. Would you get my coat for me, darling?
Okay. Thanks. Thank you for the silk negligee, honey. It's really beautiful.
Fine, Of course, I fully plan to inspect that with you as soon as I'm back. Is that all, Miss Brimer?
No. Is she still there, Lenny? Can you talk?
Are you all right?
Yeah, I called you because...
Jenny?
Actually, it's something really terrific. I've been offered another job, and it's a really wonderful chance. And they said that I would have to come right away. So I thought that I would call you so you would have a chance to start finding a replacement for me.
Replacement? What are you talking about?
I'm taking another job.
Look, I don't understand any of this. What are you saying? You can't just run off like that. Oh, I think the lining in that one's torn.
Where?
Actually, I prefer the gray one, if you don't mind.
Oh, Leonard, you're going to be late.
Even think of leaving. What is it? What's wrong?
Nothing. So I have to think about my future, Lenny. I have to.
I don't know what any of this is about, but...
Lenny, I've made up my mind. And I'm going. I'm sorry.
Talk this over. Now just listen. Yes, Miss Brimer. Thank you very much. The filing date completely slipped my mind.
I'll drive up first thing in the morning. Meet you at the office.
Sure. Absolutely certain.
The doctor says I'm almost 3 months pregnant.
You were just going to take off without even telling me about it?
Well, Lenny, I can't be the cause of ruining your career, you know, even your whole life. I won't do that. I got the name of a doctor. It's in another town. And all I need is...
No, absolutely not. I won't hear of it. No abortion.
Lenny, I can't stay here and have a baby. No family, no father. What are people going to say?
I'm not going to let you leave me.
I don't want to leave you. There's nothing else that I can do.
Yes, there is.
Isn't she just beautiful, Lenny?
She is so beautiful. So are you.
She looks like you, don't you think so?
Maybe you. Just a little. Just a little resemblance.
Have you ever seen such tiny little fingers? Do you want to hold her?
She's so delicate.
She's not going to break. Come on. Take her. Isn't she just the sweetest little thing you've ever seen? What are we going to name her?
We can't do that. It's against the rules. Didn't you talk to the woman from the adoption agency?
I told her I wasn't ready yet. Don't be mad at me. It's just I know that we agreed to put the baby up for adoption, but I hadn't seen her, and I hadn't held her. And Lenny, I was thinking that I'm never ever going to see my baby again, and I just couldn't do it. Not yet. Lenny, please.
How are you doing?
I'm sorry, but I do have to take the baby now. The new parents will be here soon, and I have to get her ready so they can take her home.
Remember? Remember that cabin with the red roof from our first vacation?
No, I remember. No running water. No indoor plumbing, no heat. That's why we're staying in a suite in a lodge this time.
Oh, I wouldn't have minded the cabin. Oh, I know. Don't use your famous logic on me and tell me that we can't go back as everything changes.
Everything certainly does. You're proof of that. You're even lovelier now.
Oh, gosh, honey. Oh. What's the matter?
John, I...
Well, you know what? I love you too.
There is something more.
What is it, Leonard? What is it? Come on, tell me.
There's someone else, John.
What are you talking about? Leonard, what do you mean? Someone else?
Yes.
You mean another woman?
Yes. Please, Joan, try to understand. We can work things out.
Work things out? What are you talking about, Leonard? What do you want? You want a divorce?
Oh, no, certainly not. Not a divorce. I love you. You know that. That's why I'm telling you. I could have just walked away. It would have been easier than facing you with this, but I couldn't do that. There's a child. A baby girl. Her name is Sharon. She...
Oh, I don't hear anything. No, I don't
Joan,
want to hear anything.
Listen to me. I've analyzed the situation. I've arrived at the only possible solution. The child needs a home. We can give her a loving home. We've always wanted a girl, and since we can't have any more children...
I can't have any more children. Is that why you've done this, Leonard?
Oh, no. She's my child. I want to do the right thing.
You want to do the right thing by whom? Is this your solution? Is this what you want? You want me to bring up another woman's child?
No, I want us to bring up my child.
I can't believe you, Leonard.
I have a responsibility to this child, and I'm not going to turn my back on her. It's the only way. I want us to stay together. I love you. Joan, I love you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Sharon. Happy birthday to you.
Yay! Happy birthday, Sharon. Now, can we have the cake, Mom?
Presents first, okay?
Can I give her mine?
Sure.
Here, Sharon.
There we go.
Look at this! A round of a Sharon. Oh, that's nice.
Cut my finger.
You okay?
Yeah, I just want to wash it off. I'll be right back. Go ahead with the presents.
Wow, Sharon! Ooh.
What are you doing here?
It's Sharon's birthday.
Any idea what could happen if Joan sees you?
I wanted to see her.
You shouldn't have come.
No. I got a present for Sharon. It's a little silver spoon.
I can't give it to her now.
Well, maybe later.
It's just a weekend away. It's not going to be that long.
Yes, it will. It's different for you, Lenny. You've got a family to go home to. When you're gone, I'm all alone. All by myself.
I never let you on, Jenny. You know how much John and those kids mean to me. Thank you.
is it?
I want Sharon back. I've thought about it. And I want her here with me all the time. I want my daughter back.
You decided from the start that you would give her up.
I know, Lenny. And I've tried. I've tried to do everything just like you said. I can't. It's wrong. She should be with me, with her mother.
We agreed that a child needs a mother and a father. John is wonderful with Sharon. She's raising
her. No, no! It's not the same, and I know that. It's not like my aunt was mean to me or anything. But not having my real mother and not growing up with her, I just don't want that to happen to Sharon.
Do you know what would happen if you tried to raise a child here without a father? The attitude of this community.
I can't live without her. I am her mother, and I have a right to her. Lenny, all I want is Sharon. I want her, and I need her. And I need you. What are you saying?
Just that. Her mother's gotten married and wants Sharon back.
But she didn't care. She gave Sharon up. Oh, Leonard, how could you get involved with someone like that?
It's beside the point
now.
No,
it isn't.
It was wrong of me to ask you to raise another woman's child. But now that's all changed. Sharon can have a home and be raised by her own mother.
She's happy here. She's part of the family. She belongs here. This wouldn't have happened if we adopted her like I wanted to.
But we couldn't have adopted her. That would have been impossible.
Why? You're her father.
Any adoption has to go through the court. When they checked the hospital records, everything would have come out.
I don't care.
Caroline, don't you realize what a scandal like this would mean to the boys when they're growing up? We can't do that to them. Or to Sharon. I'm afraid we have no choice.
It's not fair.
I know. She has hired an attorney and threatened to sue. You know what that means. Newspapers, sensationalism, everything exposed.
You're a lawyer. Isn't there something you can do?
Judge.
Here, Lenny, I'll take her.
No, I've got her. It's all right. Don't worry, darling. It won't take long. It's just a standard ceremony. Only this way we can keep our secret.
And it'll be just like a regular marriage?
Well, without a divorce, we won't actually be legally married. But this means I'm committing permanently to you and Sharon. Anything else would be morally wrong.
I understand.
Hello. Hello, I'm Judge Grantland. No, please be seated. Well, let's see now. The mother's name is Virginia Ann Brimer, B-R-I-M-E-R, is that correct? No current occupation. And the father's name is Donald Herrick, H-A-R-I-K, insurance investigator. But I see you haven't listed the name of the firm you're employed by.
Well, that's because he works on his own for different companies. Undercover, sort of like a private detective.
I see. Now, the child in concern, is it a natural issue of your union?
Well, she's our child, if that's what you mean.
Well, everything seems to be in order. If you'll both stand and face me, My clerk will serve as a witness. The groom's on the left.
Here, I'll take it.
We are gathered together to witness the joining in marriage of Virginia Brimer and Donald Herrick. You are about to enter a sanctified covenant that is hoped will last as long as you both shall live. You swear that there is no moral or legal reason why either of you should not participate in this marriage ceremony and be joined as husband and wife. I so swear.
I swear.
Now, as you say your vows, I ask you not to take them lightly, but to consider their deepest meaning. How about another slice of turkey for everyone?
One more slice of turkey, I'll take it.
Thanksgiving only comes once a year.
Oh. Your mom.
Oh, darling, thanks.
I'm watching my diet.
I'm not.
Good, Dad. That's the way. Daniel, William.
No, thanks.
How about a little more for you?
John, everything.
A little more?
Oh, it was real good, but I'm full. May I be excused to go practice on my new computer?
Hey, Billy, you want to play my new computer game with me?
Just one moment. Have you forgotten? In this house, on Thanksgiving, we say grace after dinner, too. We thank thee, O Lord, for thy bounty, and humbly pray that we may continue on the path of righteousness and love, guided by thy light. Amen.
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 Okay, boys, you can go.
Thanks, Dad.
See you, fellas.
Thanks again for the computer, Dad. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome, son. Enjoy.
Is everything all right? She's fine. John, dear, would you like some Africa dishes? Okay, if you're sure. John.
Well, how about an after-dinner brandy and a cigar while the ladies finish up in here?
Well, I don't know. Mother and I have a long drive.
No, it's early yet.
Oh, well.
Look at the time. You forgot to remind me. I almost forgot my appointment. Well, it's been wonderful seeing you all, but I've got to run or I'll be late.
Don't worry, Leonard.
Forgive me.
Myself.
All right. Thank you, darling.
Yes.
Can't you at least stay until my mother and father leave?
Darling, you know I have to meet about that outside estate consultation I've been having.
But why does it have to be today?
Because the man I'm meeting with is only in town for the holiday.
Why doesn't he go home for Thanksgiving like everybody else?
Well, he doesn't have a family of his own, I'm afraid.
Fine, invite him here.
I couldn't do that.
Why not?
Because he's just passing through town. Darling, I'm late already. I've got to go. You understand?
No, I don't, Leonard. I really don't understand why you can't do something today.
Because it's the only time he can make it. I'm sorry. Hey, I love you. What? This was the best Thanksgiving ever.
What's your favorite?
Oh, I've had more than enough.
Is there something wrong with it?
No, it's wonderful. Actually, give me a little more. It's so good.
Do you want some marshmallows? No. And do you want some marshmallows? Oh, honey, don't. She's burning from the table.
Yeah,
come on,
boy.
Stop eating.
Right?
Come here. Take a little bit more. Tom, you want a little bit more? Yes.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Okay.
Can I have salt and pepper?
Everybody wants more of Mom's wonderful stuffing. Sharon, how about you? Sharon?
Nothing.
Well, then pass it down. We've got some hungry campers here.
Thanks.
Would you like some stuffing?
More potatoes.
Oh, sweetheart, look at you. I think you got more on the outside than on the inside, huh? Come on, let me clean you up. Look at that dirty face.
It's a nice piece of white meat. Sharon, you want it?
No, thanks.
Sharon, what's the matter?
I just wanted to invite a friend from school over to spend the night. I don't see why I can't have girls come over like other kids.
Now, you know, with the kind of people I investigate, we can't be too careful.
Percy isn't a criminal or something. And besides, what do you care? You're not even here that much.
Sharon, you know it's because your dad's job, all right? Now, the whole family's here. We're all together.
But there's just us. Other families have grandparents and aunts and uncles. Cousins come over. Why don't we?
What little family we have live very far away.
I still don't understand why they never come and visit.
Sweetheart, it's Thanksgiving, okay? And your dad's here. We're all having a nice time. So why don't you try and eat something?
Sharon. It's not right.
I don't.
It's hurting you and Joan and the children.
You're the best father I've ever known. And the best husband. And the best lover.
Part-time husband and lover.
I have everything that matters. I have you and kids.
It's not good enough for you.
I never even lived in a house before. It's fine.
I want a better life for you and the kids. I'm especially worried about Sharon.
I know.
I've been offered nomination for circuit court. I'd have to stand for election, but with a party nomination, that's as good as certain.
An election? But people might find out about us.
It's a short campaign. And for the most part, it takes place in the city, not out here.
Lenny, what if something did happen? I'm happy with this house. I mean, as long as I have you and the kids. I just promise me that nothing's going to change that.
When we married, I promised to take care of you. Cherish you, and especially to love you.
And now I would like to introduce the candidate for the office of municipal court judge, district number 20, Sheila Clifford. Last, but of course certainly not least, for the office of circuit court judge, Leonard Herrick. This concludes the formal part of our Meet the Candidates evening. There will now be refreshments and an informal opportunity for you to talk with our distinguished members of the bar. Thank you.
I appreciate your support. Excuse me. Mr. Herrick.
Yes.
Don't you remember me? I'm Judge Grantland.
No, I'm sorry.
It was a mighty important day in your life when we met.
Then I probably should remember it, but I'm afraid I don't.
I'm the judge who married you in my chambers. I remember your wife. In particular, remember that she was holding a...
This is my wife.
I'm sorry, I didn't know you'd gotten remarried.
You've confused me with someone else, I'm afraid. Excuse us, please. Huh?
Monkeys, gorillas, alligators. What do you want to see first, sweet?
I don't see why we couldn't go to my school carnival with all the other kids.
Say, how's it going, Mr. Hirt?
All right, how about yourself?
Yeah, I'm just going to finish up the trimmer, then everything should be fine, okay?
Great, thanks.
You take care now.
Would you like me to check the oil and water, sir?
No, it's okay. Thank you.
Taking the family out for the day?
Oh, yeah. Off to the zoo. You know, it's one of the...
Hey, you didn't put in the whole $5 worth. Don't you want the rest of your gas?
Honey, what's the matter?
Listen, kids, I've got a great idea. Everybody's hungry, right?
Yeah.
Right? Okay, well, we'll get hamburgers and pizza and ice cream and go home and have a big picnic, all right?
You said we're going to the zoo. You promised.
I know, but it looks like it's going to rain.
No, it's not.
Well, honey, if your dad says it's going to rain, then I
But it's not going to rain. Mom, there's not a cloud in the sky. Guys, it's not going to rain.
You're right, you got me. It's not gonna rain. I just made that up because I didn't want to frighten you. You see, I saw one of the criminals I helped put in jail.
So I'm not afraid.
Sharon, now, you understand.
No, I don't understand, Dad. I don't understand why we can never, you know, do anything. I mean, we can never go to anything at school or into the city or someone else's house. What's wrong with us?
Sharon. You know, the most important thing in the world to me, since I have to be away so much of the time, is that you're all right. That none of the people I investigate can get back at me through you.
Dad, you always say that whenever we can't go somewhere or do something. I mean, it's just not fair. I can never do the things that I want to do.
Sweet, I have a surprise for you. Sharon? I didn't want to tell you this yet, but I found a wonderful camp in the mountains where kids come from all over. You want to go?
Summer camp?
That's right.
Are you serious?
Absolutely.
You mean I get to go to camp?
I promise.
Can I go?
I want to go to camp too.
Hey, you know your daddy's not a bank. You get to go when your turn comes, but Sharon gets to go first because she's the oldest.
That's not next year.
All right, school. Yeah. Hey, Dad, when does this camp start exactly?
A week after school's out. Okay.
Thanks, Dad.
Now for the brace. Try it.
Maybe.
Well, I'll pin it up and we'll see. Lori, I'll need some of the big ones. I should be fitting you for a tux while you're here, Mr. Harrick. You're going to need one for that victory party.
Well, it might be more prudent to wait till after the election returns are in, Carl.
Why? I told all my customers and family to vote for you. I'm sure you're going to win.
Thank you.
All right. How's that? Try it.
It's okay, I guess. Dad, could I talk to you? Excuse me. I was thinking, Dad, maybe I won't need the tux. I really should be studying for my finals.
You have plenty of time for that. Besides, this is going to be a wonderful evening.
It's only a high school dance.
How's it going to look if the class president doesn't show up, hmm? You've got to set an example.
I don't know that much about dancing. What if I stumble or something? I just can't.
I've always told you, you can do anything you set your mind to.
But dancing, that's different. I don't know any of the steps.
Laurie,
Dad.
Trust yourself. I'm sure you know a lot more about dancing than we do. Could you give David some pointers? Turn up the music, Carl.
You're really not that good.
It still makes you look better than I am.
Is very sharp.
Oh, really?
Very handsome.
Thanks.
How about some lunch?
Oh, yeah, oh, can we go to Bill's Big Burger?
Yeah, I knew you were going to say that.
Oh, sorry, mister, you okay?
It's okay, don't worry about it.
Mr. Herrick, right? Hey, how you doing? Well, dressed up all fancy like that, I wasn't sure it was you at first. So, what are you doing in town?
Just business.
Hey, how's the paint?
Fine.
Yeah, it makes the house look like brand new, don't it?
Yeah, it sure does.
How's the wife? She must be
getting close. Listen, good running into you. You take care, right?
Yeah, well, you have a good day, too, huh?
Who was that, Dad?
I don't recall his name. Obviously, he's a house painter.
Yeah. Huh? Are we getting the house painted?
Well, maybe.
Oh, what's Mom think?
Mom thinks we're going to be home at 2 o'clock. We're going to have lunch. We better get going.
And once again, Judge Herrick, congratulations on your big victory, and thanks for talking with us.
Thank you. My pleasure.
From the Welland Center for the Arts, this is Gordon Shiffrin of KXCY Action News. That's a wrap for us, guys. Thanks so much, Judge.
Thanks, Gordon.
Good to see you.
Mrs. Herrick, what do you think? Your husband, a member of the judiciary? You happy?
Yes, I am. I'm happy for you.
What does that mean?
It means I could be happier if you could find more time for us.
Honey, turn the radio. I want y'all to stay right here. I want y'all to stay right here and don't move.
Four.
Hey, you're not pulling off and leaving them on
I'll
me.
I'll be right back.
Come on.
Excuse me. I have to talk to you.
Oh, Miss Langley, isn't it? This is my wife, John.
Hello.
I'm working on a family estate matter, Mrs. Langley.
Yeah, it's a family matter. I wouldn't bother you here, but I didn't know what to do about it.
Well, why don't you come to my office later this afternoon?
No. It's something that can't wait. It's an emergency.
Excuse me for a moment, darling.
Nice meeting you, Mrs. I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
Mrs. Langley.
Mrs. Langley. It's a real pleasure to meet you too, Mrs. Hirt.
on earth are you doing here?
It's Sheila. It's the camp, let me be called.
You sure, all right?
Yeah, yeah, but do you remember those papers that we gave him, all those forms we had to fill out?
Yeah? Excuse us.
There's your vaccination record, and I must have missed it, and it has Joan's signature on it. And they want to know who she is and how they can reach her.
And what did you tell them?
Well, nothing. But they kept asking me a lot of questions, and they wanted to know why Joan is listed as Sharon's mother. And they said that they had to talk to her. Lenny, I didn't know what to say or do, so I came here. I'm sorry.
No, it's all right. Just, it's not your fault. You go home. Call the camp. Tell them, I'm coming home. Think of some excuse to get away.
Is something wrong? I mean, did someone get hurt at home?
No. Everyone's fine. I just got to take you home.
But Dad, I don't want to go home. I'm having a great time. I love it here. Tomorrow we're going to go on a hike with all the other kids.
Sweet, it just can't be helped. That's all I do. It just can't be helped.
But why?
Money. I can't afford to send you to camp right now.
But Dad, you already paid. It's a rule. Mom said you had to pay first before you could come.
Yeah, but something was wrong with the check. I don't know. We just have to go.
But I don't want to go. I want to stay here. Please? Dad, please, come on.
I've already talked to the camp director. I promise I'll make it up to you any way I can.
No. There's no way.
Sharon. Your mom misses you. The kids miss you. You belong there with them.
No, I don't. I don't belong there. I don't belong anywhere.
And now a special honor. One which is not given at every graduation, but which this year is fully deserved. The university's Holmgren Award for the graduate whose perseverance, determination, and dedication have reflected the highest traditions of our university. This year's recipient is graduating with honors and has already been accepted on a scholarship into Stanford University's prestigious School of Law. It is my very great pleasure to present the Holmgren Award this year to David Jordan Herrick.
Congratulations, David.
Thank you. I want to thank Dean Moulton, my professors, my faculty advisors, and above all, my family. My brothers William and Daniel. My mother, who was always there for me, and whom I could always count on for encouragement and support. And to my father, Judge Leonard Herrick, who believed in me and made me believe in myself. Who never let me give up, who taught me that there is no disability, no handicap that cannot be overcome by faith, determination, and love. Without that faith, that love, I would not be here, standing, to accept this award. Thanks, Dad.
Get closer. I've got to get you all in the frame. Come on, move in.
You know, you didn't need to say all that about me in your speech.
Maybe I didn't, but it's something I always wanted to say.
Too much.
Hey, smile. Hold it. Got it.
Oh, I'm so proud of you.
That's great. Won't be long if I get caught for jaywalking. I'll have David for a lawyer and Dad for a judge. No problem. You know, Dad, he'd probably give you a life sentence.
Now, wait a minute. That makes it sound like I'm called a hanging judge.
What makes you think you are?
Oh, come on. I'm hungry. Let's have some lunch. Why don't you get ready and we'll pick you up outside.
Okay.
How about if Daniel and I go with you?
Oh, great.
Don't you think David would like to celebrate with his friends?
He's going to. At home. It's a secret. It's going to be a surprise party.
Today?
Yes.
I wish you'd told me.
Darling, come on. You know that you're hopeless about keeping secrets.
Well, you should have told me anyway. Unfortunately, I have an important court matter to take care of today. I'm sure I can join you later.
No. Whatever it is, Leonard, you put it off. For once. How often does your son graduate from college? This is David's day.
I'll call my clerk.
Honey, it's your birthday. Your dad's coming. Sharon, the kids are all having a party for you. Can't you ask Mike to come back later?
Mom, I said I'd be back in time, okay?
I'll be there in a minute, okay, Mike?
Hello.
Hi, I'm not talking to you. Lenny, it's her birthday. You know how upset she can get.
Happy birthday.
I'll tell her. That was your dad on the phone. He's not coming, is he? He had to go out of town with his job suddenly.
Yeah, I knew it.
I mean, there's always some reason why he can't ever be here. He just shows up when he feels like it, and then he's gone again. Honey, he tries to come.
Mom!
You are always covering up for him. No matter what he says, you just do. Doesn't even matter if he's here or not, even if it doesn't make sense. Because I love him, and he loves me. How can you be so sure when he's gone so much? Honey, there are a lot of things you don't understand.
No, you don't. If he loved you so much, he'd be here more. He'd find a way. Nothing would stop him, nothing.
Sharon!
I'm coming!
Have a good time. Mm-hmm.
You take this. All right, I'll take it. Take that.
It's about time. I'm having it all day, you know.
Yeah? Well, I have.
Yeah, so what's the score then? What do you want to do?
Oh, it's my birthday. Let's celebrate it.
All right.
Let's do this. Almost midnight. Who is this boy? Where did she meet him?
I don't know.
Except I think he works at the plant where they make parts for missiles. Mm. She's young, Lenny. Like I was when I first met you.
Now, that's altogether different. You didn't take off with some irresponsible kid.
Do you still love me as much as you did when we first met?
What?
Do you?
More than ever. Okay. I've got to go. Oh, give this to Sharon for me. A bracelet, I had her name engraved on it. Tell that girl I love her, and that I'm sorry.
Do I look all right?
Yeah, you look great.
Are you sure?
Look, stop worrying. I told you, I know one of the secretaries and personnel. Job's all set. Never been in prison nor had any illegal foreigners in your family, right? So don't worry about it. Okay, here we are. Look, I have to deliver all this stuff before lunch. So when you're done, wait for me here, okay?
Okay.
And relax.
One 58 Shaker Road.
What was that address?
158 Shaker Road.
No, I've never lived there. I don't even know where that is exactly.
Well, perhaps a cousin with the same name?
No, I don't have any relatives that I know about. Are you sure? Sharon Herrick.
Yes, that's what seems so odd. It's not a particularly common name. But the security check in your job application definitely shows a Sharon Herrick having lived at 158 Shaker Road.
I don't understand.
I'm afraid I don't either. Possibly there's just some confusion. But of course, since we do work for the government, we couldn't hire you until it's all cleared up. I am sorry, Miss Herrick.
Yes?
Hi, this is 158, isn't it? 158 Shaker Road?
Yeah.
Does anybody by the name of Herrick live here?
Well, I'm David Herrick.
Does anyone else live here by that name?
Sure, my mom's here. Did you come to see her?
Yes.
Well, she's upstairs. Come on in, I'll call her. Mom?
Yes?
There's somebody here to see you. Listen, I gotta go. Why don't you wait in the living room? Thank you.
My father.
What?
Please, wait, don't go. What do you mean? Wait, wait, please.
What are you saying?
That he's my father. He's not a judge. He's an insurance investigator. He lives with my mother at 4411 Mary Lane in East Newton.
That's ridiculous. He's my husband. He's always lived here with my children and me.
Sharon! Hey, Sharon, you all right?
That you would even make such a claim. I want to make it absolutely clear, it is the conviction of this court that any diminution of petitioner's income through ineptness or lack of perseverance is not the fault of his former wife.
If the bench please...
Your client still has a moral and a legal obligation to support his former wife, and he will either meet that commitment or face contempt charges. Petitioner's motion to reduce spousal support payments is denied or dismissed. The court will stand adjourned.
I kept praying that it wasn't true, but I knew it was. How could you have done this to us?
Because I love you. Because I wanted you to have a father. Family. A name. Because I wanted you and I couldn't give you up.
You ever said to me was a lie. Every time we couldn't do something because you said you were afraid for us, you lied. Every time you didn't come home, you lied.
I love you, sweet. You know that's not a lie. I always have loved you. No matter what you're thinking, it's not nearly as bad as it may seem. Let me explain.
No. Why don't you first explain it to Joan and the boys?
Joan?
Yes, Joan!
What have you done?
I don't ever want to see you again.
Sharon! Sharon! Sharon!
Your Honor, do you want to call a deputy?
What?
A deputy?
No, no. No, that's all right. Thank you. Please.
Just a minute.
Could you wait? Wait, just a minute. Lenny called. You.
I should have known. Maybe I did.
Brian keeps hitting me.
She started.
Come on, come on, come on. I'm sorry.
Yours?
Mine and Lenny's. We have seven.
You have seven? How long has this been? Oh, never mind. I don't want to know.
No, wait. I can send the kids to their rooms and you and I can talk.
I don't want to talk with you.
I love Lenny and I can't help that.
Well, that justifies everything, doesn't it? That really justifies the way you've hurt me and my children. No, it doesn't.
Well, no, wait, what are you gonna do? I'll give you anything. Lenny, these kids, they're my whole life. You have to understand.
Why? Why should I? I can't.
I deceived you. But I swear I'll make it up to you any way you want.
I just want you out of here. Tonight. Now.
Understand that I love you.
How can you say that to me?
Because it's true.
How dare you say that?
I love you. I always have. I can't remember a minute when I ever stopped loving you.
Oh, that's why you ran off with that woman?
It's not that I love you any less. Too. I love both of you. You're both. How could I let one of you go? How could I choose between you?
You don't have to now, Leonard, do you? You can have her. Because I don't care what you do. Just as long as you get out of here.
Joan, think of the boys.
Have you thought about the boys?
Don't you think it would have been easier for me to just walk away? But I couldn't do that to them. I believe in commitment. I wanted them to have a home, a family, a father.
They do. They have a father. They have a father who's a bigamist.
Joan, please don't. I love them. I love the boys. I think we need to get some perspective on this.
Oh, yes. Perspective. Boy, you're always so good at twisting things so that they meant just what you wanted them to. I think I helped you to do it. Not this time.
All I'm trying to say is, for the boys' sake, if we don't handle this rationally...
Don't you think I know the damage that this would do the boys? Do you think that I want them or anyone else knowing what you've done to me? Do you? I don't. I have no intention of mentioning this to the boys or to anyone. In fact, I have no intention of ever mentioning your name again, except to file for a divorce.
Divorce? No, don't. Joan, please try to understand.
What should I understand? Is there some way that you can justify this? Is there? No. Because you let me go on living a lie all these years. Because you let me go on believing that you actually loved me. No matter. You might just as well have spit in my face. Goodbye, Leonard.
Sharon!
Get up, all right?
Mike?
Yeah, so what?
Where's Sharon?
In your business.
Mike, I know she's in there. Get her out here now.
She doesn't want to see anybody.
Get her out here now!
What? You're gonna get hurt.
Oh, son, it hurts. Take it easy. Take it easy. He's gonna take it easy, son.
What do you want?
I want to talk to you.
I'll bet you do. What, are you afraid I'm gonna screw things up, huh? Spill the beans?
Come with
no,
me right
just
now.
Get away.
Come with
just
me.
Go. Just get away.
I'm not going anywhere without you.
Fine. Give me the keys to the car.
Mike, listen to me. You've been drinking. Don't do this. Sharon, come home with me right now.
What right do you have to tell me what to do?
I'm your father.
No, you're not. You're someone who came to dinner sometimes. I don't have a father. I never will. I'll just keep being your little bastard.
We'll be right back.
Alan Engel. Please report to surgery now.
Excuse me. We had a call. Sharon Herrick, is she here?
Yes, she's here.
Where is she? Can we see her?
Is she all right? I think you'd better talk to Dr. Burnham. He's in surgery now, but...
Right now!
I'm sorry. She died before the ambulance reached us.
Wait. Excuse me. No, that's...
Excuse me, Judge Herrick. The girl who was killed when she ran into the school bus, she's listed as a Sharon Herrick. Was she a relation of yours? Why did the hospital call you, sir? Did you know the girl? Will you answer the question, Judge? Was Sharon Herrick related to you?
Yes. I'm her father.
Let us remember that the ways of our Lord Jesus Christ are not always clear to us mortals. It is not for us, the living, to question those ways, but rather to accept. We reverently bring the body of our beloved sister to be buried, with all its weaknesses and human imperfections. May God give her a merciful judgment and forgive all her sins. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, lead her safely home to be at one with God, our Father. May she enjoy a life of everlasting peace and tranquility. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
I need to take the kids back to the car.
Yes.
My fault.
How long have you been living with this other woman? Exactly how many children do you have with her?
When did you meet her? How did you keep it a secret for so long? How did you get enough to support them both?
Judge, do you believe in polygamy? Are there any other wives? What's your secret with women?
Are you gonna get this barred? Is the DA gonna prosecute you?
Thank you.
Come on, kids, let's go to the house.
Somehow. Can you?
No. No, I don't understand.
I tried my best. That's all I could do. Forgive me.
I don't know what I feel yet. Maybe I never will completely. All I know is that you're still my father. You might need me now.
God, I do.
Herrick resigned from the bench, restricted forever from acting in a judicial capacity. But he was not prosecuted, since Joan, his first wife, declined to bear witness against him. The judge and Virginia Brimer were legally married, and he continues to maintain relationships with all his children. Joan has remained unmarried since the divorce.